Yesterday, the folks at BeagleBone.org gave us a sneak peek at the specs of the new BeagleBone that they're going to be releasing at the end of April. Not a lot of details, but there are some really, really juicy bits in there that I think are really exciting. If you're not familiar with the BeagleBone, it's an embedded Linux development board. It's a lot like the Raspberry Pi, except that it's a little bit more aimed at hackers and tinkerers. It looks something like this. In fact, this is exactly what it looks like. It's aimed more at hackers and tinkerers. It's got a bit more of a powerful processor on it. It has more inputs and outputs on it to do more things with hardware on it. It's also a little bit more expensive than the Raspberry Pi. The BeagleBone comes in at $89, where Raspberry Pi can be had for $35. Which brings me to the first new feature of the new BeagleBone that they're announcing, is that it's going to have a lower price. No word on how much less expensive it's going to be, but I think that's really important. It's an important part of it because one of the cool things about the Raspberry Pi was that it was $35. That was incredible. So I'm eager to see how much the new BeagleBone is going to cost. It's going to have better performance. Now, already the BeagleBone has better performance than the Raspberry Pi, and there's no word on how much faster the new BeagleBone is going to be than the current BeagleBone currently announced publicly. Another new feature of the new BeagleBone is onboard HDMI. Now, for me, the onboard HDMI on the Raspberry Pi was one of the reasons that I would choose it over the BeagleBone for some projects, because I think that having that HDMI port is critical. It lets you work with a screen really easily. You can do cool things like, I've been doing stuff with open frameworks on the Raspberry Pi and having it connect to hardware. It's a lot of fun. And in fact, I posted a video a while back of me experimenting with open frameworks on the Raspberry Pi. So now that the new BeagleBone will have HDMI, I think that will make it a really, really strong competitor to the Raspberry Pi. It's also going to have onboard flash memory so that you can boot off of the onboard memory. It'll still have the micro SD slot so that you can, if you want, boot off the onboard memory and then perhaps save data to the SD slot and have it, you know, mount it and unmount it as you use it. I think that's actually a pretty cool feature. If you're doing something maybe with data logging, you can log your data off to an SD card and then pull it out and have the thing still running perhaps. It'll also still support capes, the capes from the expansion boards. Just like Arduino has Arduino shields, the BeagleBone has capes. So that's important that you can, if you have invested in hardware already, you're fine. You can still use them. Everything else seems to be mostly the same. Now, I gotta let you in on a little secret here. I've actually had a prototype of the hardware for the last few weeks, and I haven't been able to say anything about it. So I know more details than I'm letting on right now, and I promised I wouldn't say any more than what's already out there. But I'll tell you, I've been using it. In fact, I have it in my hand, the other one in my hand right now. I'm looking at it. It looks really cool. It looks different, definitely different than the current BeagleBone. And I can't say more that I've already said and that's already out there. But if you're interested in the BeagleBone, you can pre-register to see to get an alert when the actual BeagleBone is ready to be shipped and pre-ordered. So check that out if you're interested in embedded Linux. I think we're on to some really, really cool stuff in this world. I say it a lot about how I think it's so cool that, you know, Arduino was really hot, and it still is hot, and it still is an important tool, but now we have a new set of tools that I think are just absolutely fantastic. I love that we can hook up monitors and keyboard and mice, but then still do all the stuff we do with hardware, blinking things, moving motors, reading sensors. This is incredible, and I think we're on the verge of some really, really incredible stuff. So keep an eye out for the new BeagleBone. I wish I could say more about my experience with it, and hopefully soon you'll be hearing from me about it. Otherwise, keep an eye out for it and check out the post I did on blog.makescene.com. Thank you, everybody, for watching. These video podcasts I'm doing, or these vlogs, are just a big experiment. I appreciate all the feedback I've been receiving, comments, emails to me at matt@mattrichardson.com, or tweets at mattrichardson.com. This is where you can find me. Let me know what you think about this. Send me feedback. I love to hear it, and I want to make this better and better and better, and we'll see how long I can keep it going. All right, have a great day. Bye.